love the ISUPK. Stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by Commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.
You're doing exactly the opposite of what God said, man. And you can blame America for that. America teaches us to do these things because this is not our culture. The Bible is black culture. It's black culture to be peaceable amongst our people. It's black culture to love your woman and for women to love their man. It's black culture for us to raise our children right. It's black culture for us to have regard for the poor. It's black culture for us to respect authority. So if everybody wants to say black people are out of order, it's because America has taught us to be out of order. America has taught us to be lawless. America has taught us how to be thugs and violent savages. The same way those devils were when they came over here and established America. The same way they were when they stormed the Capitol, January 6th. And the same way they're going to be in just a second. You understand? We're not talking about just history up here. We're talking about prophecy too. That's their spirit, man. That's the spirit of these devils. They hate laws. They protesting against wearing masks, which lets you know how privileged white people are. While we in the streets telling the police, don't shoot, hands up, don't shoot, my life matters. White people protesting, I don't want to wear this mask. Why? Something that's supposed to save your life. This mask, we shouldn't have to wear a mask. We're being oppressed. This is America. Right, going and walking around in circles in Walmart and Target with no mask on. Like, they're so privileged, they don't even know what to protest about. They're not oppressed. Their struggle is not our struggle. And that's why we can never join hands with them. Because their problems are not our problems. They have their problems. I'm not saying the white man doesn't have problems. I'm not saying that. But their problems are not ours. And we have to look out for our best interests the way they have always done. Racism works, man. Everybody wants to call us racist when racism works. You know, America was built on racism. The white man said, we're going to look out for our people, for the best interests of our people, and that's just that. And lo and behold, now we have America. Maybe we should look at ourselves and say, we should come together and do what's best for our people. And the Bible tells us to do that. We ain't talking about committing acts of violence. We're simply saying, how about you love your own people for a change? We fight for justice. They fight to not have their privileges restricted, man. It's a difference. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. If you want to stop the death culture in the black community, we have to stop breaking the laws in the Bible. We have to stop sinning. And this is not religious, man. This is practical. This is practical knowledge. It makes sense for black men to not kill each other when the white man wants all of us dead.
Right.
It makes sense for us not to sell our own people drugs when the white man put the drugs in our community to destroy the community. It makes sense for us not to abort our babies when they put the Planned Parenthoods in our neighborhoods to kill our people. This is not religious, man. That's practical knowledge. And that's what the Bible is. The wages of sin is death, black man, Hispanic man, Native American Indian man. We have to change our conduct and behavior, man. We don't need the white man's respect or his love. He's incapable of doing it anyways. He can't love. He will never love us, and we don't need it and we don't want it. I want the love of my fellow brother. I want the love of my fellow sister, man. We should love each other the way Christ told us to love each other. And that's by following the laws in this Bible. That's it. It's that simple, man. All we have to do is stop being a murderer, man. Give me Mark 10 and 6. I'm gonna show you something, man. I'm gonna show you how America teaches black people to go against God. It's so simple. And this is why black people wondering why the white man is able to rule over us when we clearly are stronger than them.
Give me Isaiah 32 and 5. And what did brother bring it out was super heavy, man. Let me explain something to y'all. Y'all see white people protesting the mask, protesting the COVID, open up the COVID, protesting Trump, Trump losing the election. Listen, white people are really protesting being black. That's all it is. White people are not used to being told what to do, where to go, stay in your house, don't kill this person, don't kill that person. And Trump elevated your freedoms. Trump said it's okay. When the looting stopped, the shooting starts. And you took it as license to be cruel to black men, to be cruel to Hispanic men, to be cruel to Native Indian men and women and children. White people just want a license to be cruel to us. They stormed the Capitol because their chief honcho, the racist man called Donald Trump, lost. And because he lost, they are scared now that they are going to have to reserve to be just like black people. To obey the laws of the land and be told where to go and where not to go. They, in essence, protested black people having certain freedoms. They, in essence, protesting black people's presence in America. Protest black people doing this and doing that. That whole riot at the Capitol, that was the hatred for black people. It was based on the hatred for black people. That's all it is. And they will turn around and blame us in a heartbeat for it. You got Capitol Police that are racist, DCPD that are racist. I ain't saying all of them, but a great majority of them are. And you found out on January 6th how much of you bastards are racist devils, man. You just goddamn racist. You got the Secret Service racist. You're looking for them senators to murder them. You're talking about, where's Pence? Let's lynch Pence. What happens when you can't lynch a white man? You're gonna try to lynch a black man. And that's what you all was set to do. And the Bible talks about you, man. Read what you got.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 32, verse 5. The vile person shall be no more called liberal.
Say it again.
The vile person shall be no more called liberal.
Say it one more time.
The vile person shall be no more called liberal.
Go ahead.
Nor the church shall to be bountiful.
The Bible says the vile person shall be no more called liberal, man. And and listen, black people in America, we need to wake up. We love these damn liberals. Everybody knew Trump was a goddamn problem from day one. Everybody knew it. These bad hombres, this, that, the other. Everybody knew he was a problem. But we as a people, we love the other side. We love that liberal side. But the Bible says the vile person ain't gonna be called liberal no more. What you got in office now is a vile man. And the churl mean cruel. The cruel person, he ain't gonna be called bountiful no more. And who was that cruel one? That Donald Trump, man. He was a cruel man. And America loved him. They said he was the best one for America. They said American jobs went up over him. They said it was a better economy for him. Well, I ain't seeing it.
I ain't seeing it,
but he ain't gonna be called bountiful no more, man. Y'all ain't gonna get no praise no more, you liberals and you Republicans and you Democrats. None of that. All y'all the devil.
That's right.
East wing, left wing, right wing, up wing, down wing, same bird, same chicken. The devil the Bible speaks of, man.
That's right.
All y'all the goddamn devil. Biden, Harris, Trump, Pence, devil.
That's right.
And you're evil to black people. With no apologies, man. Read on.
If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes. and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by Commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.